We're ready to begin a chapter on solutions. We're going to learn about what a solution is. We're going to talk about the energetics, the enthalpy, the entropy of solutions. And then we're going to do a lot of calculations in the world of solutions, because solutions can be concentrated and have a lot of solute in them, or not very concentrated. And then that concentration gives rise to various properties of the solutions. So let's start with some definitions. There's different types of solutions, okay? But what is a solution? We learned way back in the first, maybe the second chapter of our textbook about the term homogeneous versus heterogeneous. A homogeneous mixture, it's uniform throughout. That's a long way of saying we have a solution. So that's a definition of solution, is a homogeneous mixture. A lot of times when we think about solutions, we automatically go to the world of a liquid solution, but it doesn't have to be a liquid solution. You can have solutions that are gaseous. The air we breathe is a homogeneous mixture of various gases. We've got oxygen, thankfully. We've got nitrogen and various other gases in that air. It's uniform throughout, so it's a gaseous mixture. You can have homogeneous mixtures that are solid, and they would be called solutions. Gold jewelry is an example of that. It is not pure gold. It is a mixture of gold and silver and copper, different ratios. They mix them while they're liquid, because that's when it's easy to mix. But then it's uniform throughout and it solidifies, and it would be a solid solution. Very often in this chapter, we will be talking about aqueous solutions. Water is the universal solvent. It has dissolved so many different things, and very often we will use it as a solvent. And if it is the solvent, it is an aqueous solution. Now, different things will dissolve in their solvent to different amounts. And the maximum amount you can get to dissolve is called its solubility. So you take a certain amount of solvent, how much can you dissolve in it? There's lots of different ways of reporting solubility. You might talk about how many grams would dissolve in 100 grams of water. That would be its solubility. You could talk about how many moles would dissolve in a liter of solution. That would be its solubility. So solubility is how much you can get to dissolve. We talked about like dissolves like a while back, and so we just want to bring that to your forefront of your mind. When we talked about intermolecular forces, things will be able to dissolve in each other when they have similar intermolecular forces. In the chapter on thermodynamics, we talked about entropy, and entropy is the driving force for making a solution. Why one solute and the solvent will get together and mix in this uniform way has everything to do with entropy. So just as a reminder, one of the ways that we thought about entropy was the randomization. The more randomized it is, the more disordered it is, the more entropy it has. We talked about it in terms of microstates and maximizing the number of microstates, but it's really a tendency towards disorder, and that would be disorder for the universe if it's going to be spontaneous. So when you mix substances together, it's going to be due to the fact that the solute and the solvent as a separate entity, as a less disordered system and surroundings as the mixed together. So things have a pervasive tendency to spread out. And so you take that solute and you put it down in that solvent, and it's going to spread out. It's going to maximize the number of randomization due to that dispersal. Now, we're not going to get into numerical values of this, but not everything will mix together and form a solution. Some things will, some things won't. And it will all have to do with the value of the entropy change of the universe in order to decide whether something is spontaneously going to mix or not. Now, some things we can predict pretty easily, and we're going to look at that prediction. Some things it's more difficult to predict, and we think about our solubility rules that we had to memorize about which salts would dissolve in water. It's hard to predict, and so we were left with some memorization. Okay. Now, we know that this is not the second law of thermodynamics, that entropy tends to increase in a system. The second law of thermodynamics says the universe's entropy will increase. But we do know also that more processes that have a spontaneous within their little system, if it's more disordered, it tends to be likely to be spontaneous. So that is really the driving force of a solution. We know what a solution is. We know that it can be a solid, liquid, or gas. We know about the term solubility now, and that it is entropy that drives it. Now, we won't do any entropy calculations in this chapter, but we want to just bring forth to your mind about entropy, and that is what is going to determine whether or not a solution will form or a solution will not form. It is the bottom line.